Okay, revival teacher training, one-on-one, SUP, take one, and that's pretty much all there is. Everybody, let's thank Mo for practicing yoga on a paddleboard for the first time, and he's going to let me guide him in doing so. So, Mo, get on the board. Get in there and get on an easy seat. If there's anything you need me to show you to do, I will do that for you.
So what should I do on the board?
Just get on it and sit down to start.
I should probably put it in the wheel.
Well, it'll put you where it wants you.
So try to keep it away from the wall. Have you ever been on a paddle board before?
No.
All right, it's like a big surfboard. It'll actually float you at any point. You know what you need to get in the water? Stand up first.
No, you can start on your knees. Start on your knees so you get balanced quick. And then you'll come to your, then you'll come to, yeah. So if you can find that, you're just going to take a quick meditation right there. Relax your feet, straighten out your spine. You want to pretend that you're anchored. You're being pulled to the heavens through from your skull.
Like this.
Tuck your chin a little bit, so you're extending your spine. You want to find as much space between each vertebrae as possible. And then your bottom, there's an anchor on your earth chakra pulling you to the center.
So my butt is towards the ground and my head is towards the sky.
Exactly. And it's the universe is doing everything it can to find you as much separation in your spine as possible. Trying to keep your neck up, your head up, so that you're looking in a more put your head in a more natural position. Don't look down at your
feet. Like this?
Actually look back like that exactly. So you're looking back a little bit and you're trying to reestablish that curve in your neck.
Like this?
Yep. Is that uncomfortable on your knees?
Kind of, yeah.
Alright, can you do an easy seat?
Easy seat?
Yeah, this one.
Oh yeah, that's good.
You want to get into the center of the board so both ends are up and you don't...
Like this.
Yeah.
Oh, that's more comfortable, man.
Alright, perfect. So now let's just do some breathing. So with that erect spine like you had it...
So always have an erect spine all the time.
That is the goal. So your spine is your core. It's controlling absolutely everything else. So once it is in alignment with everything else becomes aligned. And right now, you're literally, because the ground is not there, there's no stability in any place around you.
Yeah.
Every position is literally trying to find your connection to the air around you and become as light as it, so it'll support you in whatever pose you choose to go into.
Having like an erect spine, a good posture, should it be effortless, or should I like?
Once our core muscles are actually strong enough, I totally believe having an erect spine will be effortless. Yet inside of our very computer-based lifestyles, our cores are no longer supporting our spine.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
So inside of doing yoga like this, doing deep water yoga, doing normal hatha yoga, you're increasing your core strength, which is then increasing your back. If she would have said, strengthen your core, lose weight, I'd probably still be curled in a ball and no idea that I could do whatever I wanted again.
Yeah.
All right, so just do some basic breathing, and now we're going to just actually try to connect to your breath. You're going to pay attention to it, and you want to take a 4-count inhale and a 4-count exhale, both through your nose.
Both through the nose?
Both through the nose.
So like this? How much a hold? No hold?
You can do 4, 4, 4, 4. And when you inhale, you want to actually feel it going all the way down to your toes. And when you exhale, you want to feel it leaving everywhere. Force your circulation so that the air is going from your feet to your hair to your toenails. That is your current and best guide. It will tell you what you can and can't do. Your body is the next best guide. I got some good ideas and can hopefully keep you from getting wet, but your breath and your body, if they cannot do anything I say, do not do it. Tell me you can't do it, and we will find an alternative that works for you. So, do that for 10 count while I push you to the other side, and then we're going to actually try and go into tabletops.
Okay.
I'll show you as soon as you get to the other side with your breathing.
Keep my eyes closed?
That's up to you. Whatever's more comfortable. Once you get on your back, I'm pretty sure because it's noon you're going to want to keep your eyes closed because that's really bright. So you're going to go from that position into this position. The goal is to find alignment with your shoulders and wrists,
yeah.
Knees and hips. To reposition yourself on the floor so you find center again, because that's the thing about a board versus the ground. Every movement you have to refine center. Once you're there, you know cat cows are?
Yeah, it's my favorite.
Do as many cat cows on your own as you want to.
Surprisingly, my sciatic pain flares when I move my neck. So I know it's a whole spine issue.
Well, that's the goal of trying to get it back in its original position. Sports had an impact on it, and life had an impact on it.
It's a city player.
We forget to take care of it like it's really, really important because we get busy. And
yoga will do the job?
Yoga seems to have an amazing effect in your connection to yourself and to everything around you, that life becomes way more manageable. And it for me, it was a very much persistent practice and doing it repetitively daily and expanding my practice with different teachers and different styles so that I could actually get comfortable with my yoga.
Yeah. Like this movement causes so much static pain, but becomes less by time. And I remember one instructor told me you're flossing your damaged nerve, so that's a good thing.
So what? That hurts.
This one, yeah.
Okay, so how about this one? If you go into child's pose, what does this do?
Oh, this thing is the best, man.
Okay, so let's go there for a minute. Can you get your knees further apart and your hips wider open by any chance?
Like this?
Not your feet, your hips. Your knees, so. It's go from here to here if you can, but whatever's comfortable.
Yeah.
If you can actually get your knees in the water.
The water? Water then?
If you can. It's up to you. Like I said, I'm watching. This is the first time we're doing it together, so I don't know what you're capable of or not yet. You've got to kill me. But yeah, you got to open here. When I'm open up, try to get your toes and your big toes to touch each other. Well, this will open them up. If it's uncomfortable, just come back, bring them closer together. actually it. You find your comfortable child's pose. And then whenever you need to rest, no matter what I'm saying, if you need to rest, go back to this position.
Which one?
Right, whatever your most comfortable child's pose is. That way it opens up your sciatic and straightens out your spine. All right, you ready to stand up?
Yep.
Stand up. Between your hands, bringing both sides of the body together. Take a slight twist to the right, or lean to the right, half moon, not, you just want, either way. Whatever your, whatever right works best for you, just when I go the other direction, you go the other direction. Try and lean back a little bit, try and straighten out your elbows if possible, and then go back to the other side. You can look forward, I'm not doing anything different than you because you're keeping balance, I'm just standing with that. You pay attention to the pool, I'll pay attention to what you're doing. You don't need to look at me.
Yeah.
Alright, go back to center. Hands up. And let's see where you're, do your most comfortable forward foot.
Alright, that's good.
So let's see where you can get. You're not, it's not a competition, if that hurts, go up.
No, I just have to bend my knees a bit.
That's, and you can bend your knees as much as you want. So can you do this?
Yeah.
Is that comfortable?
Yeah.
Okay, so rest your fore, your chest on there and just do some ragdolling. Relax your arms. Swing. So start, try to swing your arms around while you're just standing on your feet without falling off the board.
So stand up again?
Nope, stay down there.
Yeah.
So your elbows are in your armpits.
Yep. Yeah.
And just do monkey arms. Flatten your feet if you can. Again, I'm on the deck. This stuff is really easy up here. It's way harder when you're on the board that has no base. Try and do a swing. Bring the wrists across each other. Opening up the shoulders. And now you want to do it nice and slow. It's not about speed, it's about calm. Try not to move the board when you're moving your arms. Now you want to try to align your breath with the movement. So whenever you're constricting, you want to exhale and expel everything. Whenever you're expanding, you want to pull in all the fresh air that you can.
4-4-4?
Whatever is most comfortable for you.
Through the nose or through the
mouth? I would say through the nose until you feel hot, and then when you need to expel heat, start exhaling out the mouth. All right, let's go down, and now you're going to lay down on it.
My back?
Yep. Reverse tabletop. Okay. You're gonna go from down to side.
Okay, like a bridge.
Yes. But it's a full bridge, you're not, there's no arm.
Yeah, so how do you put your hand here?
Right here. See if you can get more of a 90 on your knees when you get them. Alright. There you go. Bring your head back, relax it all the way, and let your neck fall all the way back. Way different on a paddle board!
That's cool.
Try to bring your belly all the way up to the sun. Head back though. See if you can lift one leg. And the other?
Where I'm gonna fall, man.
Then, if you're afraid you're gonna fall, I guarantee you will. But I promise, it shouldn't bruise.
Oh yeah.
You might get wet, but I doubt you're gonna bruise.
Oh, I know, dude.
So now see if you get back into it and do the other leg.
Yeah. I'll do both of them.
Get back on your belly and let's do some cobra so you can relax your back with you with something that you know works.
Is that how people do start surfing, like paddling?
Yeah, you have to start paddling to start surfing. If you ain't moving, the wind is not going to just pick you up and let you get on.
What's that?
If you're not moving, the wind is not going to just let you get on.
Oh, yeah.
All right, put yourself back in the middle of the pool and do a couple cobras. Go through seven of them. and see if you can actually do downward dog or upward facing dog on the seventh one. So you actually push up off your, push your pelvis and your knees off the board for the last one. Try and look back at your toes if you can.
Look back at my toes?
Yeah, that's the goal. Straight over your head, straight back at your toes like you're a circle.
Should my hips leave the floor or not?
Not for the cobras, but once you get into downward dog, upward dog, yes. Can you hold it on your elbows on the floor?
On the floor?
Yeah, because then you got to take your hands away from the sides and actually like balance in the center.
Like this?
Yep.
That's easy, man.
Okay, I just wanted to check. Can you tuck your elbows in more?
Like this?
And get your hands flat?
Like this?
Like, yeah, do the thing. And now bring your feet together.
And my neck always
and your neck, yeah, like yeah, I mean, you've been to Egypt, they actually been to Egypt, so you know what the damn things look like. You're trying to look like that right now. There you go. And now see if you can pick up your pelvis and your knees. And just put everything on your hands and your toes. Because I'm just going to let you know, high plank comes next.
High plank.
So you go do upward dog, which is this. With your pelvis and your knees off the ground, head back as far as possible. And then you're going to go from that, put your toes flat, elbows straight, in the high plank. Can you get your pelvis up?
Yeah.
Or is that your pelvis up?
No, it's not.
Okay.
I'm on the ground.
Okay. And again, you want to connect your ups and downs to your ins and outs. You need to find what breath works best for you, especially when you're on a board.
And then what? Downward dog?
Upward dog.
Stay on your toes. Like a plank.
Like a plank with your hips first. And your head is actually more of a back bend than a plank. Toes flat. There you go. And then hips and knees off the board. That's it. Now roll your toes back and go up into high plank. Straighten out your back. You don't need your butt that high. You want to find straight.
Like this?
Yep. And then let's see if you can do seven taps. Each side. Lower will be way beneficial. And just so you know, if you need to take
Seven each side or seven total?
Do seven, knees down.
What do you mean?
Just do the taps with your knees just like that, just to get used to switching your balance. But don't lean back like that. You want to be as close over. You want to keep that alignment with your shoulders and your wrists, even on your knees. And then just as slow as possible, bring one up, tap, the other one, tap. It's more about making sure you're reestablishing alignment every time you reset your hand on the board than it is about how fast you can do it. Plank to low plank to upward dog.
So
and then to downward dog.
High plank to low plank.
So find your downward dog and then find out whatever you can move, wherever's most comfortable. If you need to bend your knees, however your downward dog's gonna look, you just wanna hold that for about 15 breaths right
so
now.
So taps or downward dogs now?
Huh?
Taps or downward dog?
Did you finish your taps?
No.
Well, finish your taps. Then, see, I'm getting ahead because you're just slow. I thought you were further along. My fault, Bo.
You're good, man.
You are as light as this.
What's that?
You are as light as this. I am as light as air. I am as light as air. Not what your knees are doing, not what your hands are doing. You are as light as air. As soon as you're connected to your environment, anything is possible.
So what's the next one? I lost that.
So now you're going to try and go through a chaturanga so you get a high plank. And then you're going to lower to low plank. Fold your toes under. Lift to upward dog, and then step back into downward dog.
Okay. So,
and once you're there, now you just want to do 15 in and out breaths. Whatever movements are comfortable.
What's in and out
just
breath?
Breathing. Yeah, just breathing.
And downward dog.
Any organic movements you want to do in your downward dog. But the goal here is 15 breaths. And try to get as still in your downward dog as you can once you find out whatever tweaks and twists and movements you need to do. See if you can get your heels flat, even if you got to move them forward.
Coming, bro.
You weren't supposed to. I was just trying to get you back in the middle of the pool.
Yeah, I was focused on my breath.
You have to be focused on both.
Oh, yeah.
But that was a nice cool down, wasn't it?
Yeah, I was looking forward for it. Kind of pushed myself.
Flat feet.
bend your knees more and keep your feet flat. Compensate for your with your movement. There you go. And I mean, the more consistent you are, the more your hamstrings are going to open up, and you're nowhere near the center of that floor. Okay.
It's so fun, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's really hard to be serious when you just keep getting wet.
Oh yeah.
All right, can you do the lat yogi squat?
Hands off the board?
If you can.
Think you could give me a push?
Yes.
In case.
So you want to go feet to the side, elbows to knees if possible, and do your prayer hand.
Heels on the floor. Huh?
Heels flat if you can find it.
Like this?
Try and straighten out your back so you're actually upright.
Like this? No, I'm bending
forward.
Come
up like this. Go wide feet. Hands in.
Losing focus, man.
Every time you're not, you're going for a swim.
Yeah. We're gonna lie, after the first fall, it's tempting.
So find balance on the outsides of the board with your toes, and then heel toward the center, that like that black handle right there.
Like
try what? And point your two heels at that. Start to lower yourself, and the trick is you want to bring your butt down and keep your back straight.
I think it's hip mobility.
Well, and that's only go as far as you can. Your back is not straight. Come back up. So as soon as your hips are not happy with you right now, in my opinion, right this second, because what you're doing from what I can see is as soon as you try to come down, you're doing this.
Oh, it's because of hip, right?
Well, it's whatever's got this all locked up.
Yeah.
So what we're shooting for, and I don't do it perfectly anywhere near it, is you want to come straight down so that you're literally in that picket fruit position.
Yeah.
Get in birth position.
Poop, yeah.
Yeah, poop in position, and that'll open up your hips eventually, but don't push it, just open up your hips as far as you can.
Like this?
That's way closer.
Yeah, my hips are very open.
So that you mean we just start doing hip openers?
Yeah.
Okay, go for a swim by choice because you got life on you and you shouldn't be there right now. Go for a swim.
We shouldn't be there.
The bead is on your shoulder, so go for a swim. You left. I think he just wanted to say hi to me. You got
being practicing yoga with you and everything already.
Dude, like, the merrier, what do you say, the more the merrier?
Always. Do you surf a lot?
I try to.
Where do you surf?
Right out in front. Actually, I paddle more right now because there hasn't been that much surf here.
Yeah.
So I just paddle out to the kelp beds a lot. So this time, we're going to get back on. Let's go back to your back.
Back?
Yeah. And we're just going to relax it out and close.
I was thinking of doing one more thing.
Okay, let me see what that is on your own, and then we'll go to what's up. You know what Final Shavasana is, right? I'll show you that one as soon as you show me what you're about to do. And then can you dance? You're not a salsa or anything?
I've been learning. Started last week.
Well, let's see if you can do your first lesson on the paddle.
Salsa?
Yeah.
Dude, I'm a bad dancer. I dated a girl in college. She was in the salsa club.
Uh-huh.
And I went to one class and all the girls said I had the worst coordination ever.
Well, that's because you were probably thinking about it instead of just doing the music.
Yeah, and I was like used to basketball script.
Oh, gotcha.
Heavy movement.
Well, yeah, because you got people piling into you. You gotta know, it's more like football nowadays. See if I can do plow. So this is like, this is waterfall.
Yeah.
And then.
Yeah, yesterday I tried doing that.
That's plow. That takes, it's not, I mean, I don't know where you're at inside of flexibility. I don't think you're going to get into plow yet, but I want to see how close you can get into plow that's comfortable. If it hurts, if it's too much, stop.
I started it yesterday, heard the static pain, but then I felt like someone is like stretching my whole spine, especially like the SI joint. That felt amazing.
Which is the goal, is we want to open up, we want to fold you in half so that whole spine opens up.
Yeah, I have like six degenerated discs.
Yeah, and then because that way when you're, as you connect your breath to your circulation and your movement, you'll actually be able to breathe into your spine. So for me, one of the big ones was I couldn't stand and I would try at elevators.
Yeah.
Because at the 2-minute point, I would have to do this.
Yeah.
And that was the only thing that would give me the space. Consistently doing this over here, I now have enough core strength where I can engage my core.
Yeah.
And make my lower back stop hurting.
So what fucked up your back originally?
Life.
Yeah. I think it's like computer life.
Same thing that messed up my neck, climbing around like a monkey, sitting around eating McDonald's, going to the drive-thru. One of my most cool memories was my son. We pulled up to a Carl's Jr. I looked at him and he goes, well, what do you want? Because I had the whole memory ahead, like locked in. And I mean, I was getting a meal and two sandwiches because the meal just wasn't enough. And then when he looked at me, he goes, what do they have? It was like a moment of, oh my God, at least he doesn't eat this junk all the time.
Oh, that was, yeah. It was a proud father moment, huh?
And I mean, I love Carl Jr. They're a great creative writer, so I don't get sued by anybody.
Yeah.
But preservatives is not the best thing for me.
Yeah. For me, I think it's sitting a lot when you throw the basketball without front Jordan. Don't get me started on the Jordan.
The stretching and everything afterwards.
Yeah.
I got really lucky because I swam.
We used to go like to Asian tournaments.
Uh-huh.
Like the Chinese team, the Japanese, the Iranian team, they would have doctors, assistant, conditioning. Dude, the Jordanian team, we used to smoke with the Syrian team after games, after we get our asses kicked. Dude, it was so bad. Like, they didn't even pay us for 8 months. Like, so corrupt. We made it to the Youth Olympics. It was in Argentina. And it was the youth team. I was 16. And we went, and the Olympics pay for our plane tickets, the Olympic committee. They paid the Jordan Federation. The guy, the owner who's responsible, took the money for himself and then booked the cheapest tickets possible. It took us 3 days to arrive to Argentina. Jet lag us, fucked our games in 2 days.
Oh, good lord.
Don't get me started at the corruption.
Well, just inside of the corruption everywhere in the world, let's just shavasana our way a hell of out of it. Let's see how far in Nepal you can get without swimming. You're nowhere near the wall.
So wherever do my hands go again?
Wherever you can find balance on the board, but that bee is on your nipple. He's very fond of you.
My nipple?
He is.
Who's that?
The bee. I wouldn't swat him. I just make sure you know he's there. He probably just wants to say hello.
Yeah, probably.
But I don't want him to try and kill himself in your head just because he's scared of you.
Can you give me a push from the wall?
Yeah, I'm going to do that right now. Okay, now do your plow, and then from plow you're going to go into final shavasana, and that's just corpse pose. So you're going to try and find absolute calmness and just float for about 5 minutes. I'm going to set completely up and tell you how long it's been. Can you straighten your knees? Bye.
That's
cool. Try and find balance, and now literally just try to take a nap. If because you got the lower back issues,
yeah.
If you need to bend your knees, go for it.
I don't think I could do that thing, my feet towards the board.
Huh?
I don't think I could do that. My feet towards the board.
Not yet. It's only the first day.
Maybe
it's okay. Yeah, find balance, move the head up, and then just literally you're going to lay down for 5 minutes. Put your hands in the water if you want. Feet too.
want me to just take off and leave, go ahead and wave your hand. If you're ready to wake up and go back up, let me know. Nice, easy. Roll over to a nice fetal position on your left side if you can.
Fetal position?
Yeah, get back into an easy, you want to go to an easy seat, but just put yourself on your left side in a fetal position. Blaming her for it.
So time to get back on land?
Once you're up, you get back into an easy try. Can you get your back into a cross leg easy seat?
Get your nice little pose out.
Thank the air for your limited swimming ability. Thank the water for catching you and not having to hit the ground. Bring your hands to heart center. Just find connection within you. I wanted to thank you, and I'm honored to share your yoga with you. And humbled by you allowing me to be your guide. Get your hands to your third eye. Find connection with everything. And a nice easy bow, namaste. How you feel?
I feel awesome, bro.
Is that cool or what?
It's awesome. This is the most awesome yoga ever done. Dude, I'm very grateful, man. Thank you.
Thank you. Alright, I'm shutting the video off now.